हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सुनीता पवार, लेक्चरर ऑफ ENC डिपार्टमेंट, HJPM ट्रस्ट पॉलिटेक्निक नरसोशी। टुडे वी विल सी द थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ डेटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड नेटवर्किंग, कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी द फीचर्स ऑफ वायर्ड लैन। सो फर्स्ट फीचर, सिक्योरिटी। एज वायर्ड नेटवर्क आर कनेक्टेड बाय फिजिकली प्लगिंग इन ए केबल from one device to another, it is much more difficult to access them without authorization. Second feature, reliability. Wired network bring with them a reliable, constant download and upload speed unaffected by environment. Third, easy to use. The details depends on the computers and devices on the network. Plugging an Ethernet cable into a laptop or printer is enough for to recognize the network. Get connected. Distance. Ethernet cabling is a contrast can stretch up to 330 feet without any loss of quality. Cost. Ethernet cables, hub and switches are very inexpensive. Performance. Wired LANs offers superior performance. So these are the features of wired LANs, and on this you are getting the question for 5 marks. Now we'll see the Ethernet. Ethernet is an extremely popular LAN technology used by several thousand LANs around the world. Ethernet uses a single coaxial cable as a transport medium. A device called transceiver is used to establish the connection between a computer and a Ethernet. So the transceiver is responsible for sending voltage on a cable and interpreting the signals. These voltages are indicates status. Each host as the NIC controls the operation of its transceiver using the network software inside the host. Ethernet have three status. First, the bus is idle, means no host sending or receiving any message. Bus is busy, that time any one of the host can send or receiving the message. Third, the bus carries an erratic signal generated by collision, means at a time maybe number of the host they are sending the messages. So if the NIC of one computer is replaced with another, then the hardware address of the computer changes to the address of the new NIC. This is same as a SIM card of mobile phone. Ethernet properties. First, broadcast network. It is a broadcast network because each host receives every transmission from all hosts on the network. Best effort delivery. It does not provide any information to the source if the frame sent by it has successfully reached the destination. Third, decentralized access control. The Ethernet uses the approach of CDMA/CD. Fifth, protocol simplicity. Use bus topology and relative low cost. These are the properties of Ethernet. Now we will see the Ethernet frame. So in this total 6 fields are present in this frame. So first is the preamble, destination address, source address, frame type, frame data and CRC code. And below one it showing the how many bytes are used for each one field. Now we will see the detail. The Ethernet is a data link layer connection between hosts. The unit of data exchanged by the host over the Ethernet is called as a frame. First field in the Ethernet frame is the preamble. It contains 8 bytes, means 64 bits of alternating zeros and ones to help the receiving host to synchronize. Destination address. The destination address field is a 6 bytes address and contains the physical address of the destination station. Source address. The source address field is also 6 bytes and contains the physical address of the sender of the packet. Frame type. This field identifies the type of data carried in the frame. Frame data. This field contains the actual data of the frame, which can be variable length. Next, CRC code or cyclic redundancy check. This 4-byte field helps the destination NIC to detect transmission errors. So on this you are getting the question for the 5 marks. With this frame format you have to explain the all the fields. Next, token ring. So this one token ring is same as a ring topology. So in this the diagram is shown as here. The token ring network is based on ring topology and employs a mechanism called token passing. All hosts on the token ring share the same physical medium. In this case of token ring, hosts are arranged in form of circular ring. When a host on the ring wants to transmit the data, it cannot send it immediately. It must wait for the permission to do so. However, once a host gets a permission for data transmission, it is guaranteed that no other host would be allowed to transmit data at the same time. The sending computer transmits a frame which travels across the ring. Each host on the ring network compares the destination address. If match, then only copy the frame, otherwise just forward it to next host. When destination host match the address, then before it forward the frame, that host checks the CRC to ensure that there are no errors, and then not only accept the frame but also changes a flag bit in the frame to indicate the receipt of the correct frame. The frame comes back to the sender after covering the entire ring. At this stage, the sender can check the flag bit to verify that frame successfully received or not. This bit or this flag bit check facility or acknowledgement scheme is not allowed in the Ethernet. So this one is a working of a token ring network. So on this topic also you are getting the question for the 5 marks. In this you should draw the diagram and explanation. Next we will see the working of fiber distributed data interface, that is a FDDI. The main properties of FDDI are the token ring for media access control, that is a MAC, and self-healing. These are the main properties of the FDDI. FDDI operates exactly like token ring with one difference. Token ring employs a single wire through all the host in the network. FTTI hardware uses two independent rings to connect to every host. Normally, FTTI use only one ring for data transmission and the secondary ring remains ideal. If either one break, the other can be used as a backup. It works like a token ring network. The NIC of each host examines all the frames that circulate around the ring, comparing the destination address in the frame with its own. Host keeps a copy of a frame only if the two addresses match, else it simply forwards it along the ring. Now we will see the self-healing mechanism in FTTI. So as shown in diagram, already I told they are using the two token rings, but during the transmission they are using only one, and another one ring it's has a backup only. If suppose any one of the ring or first ring is failed to work, then automatically they are transmitting the data using the second ring. In the self-healing mechanism, two possibilities are there. One, if suppose first ring is not working or failed to work, then the automatically data will transmit it using the second ring. That is the first self-healing mechanism. If suppose in this FTTI setup, if any one of the host is failed, then they are isolate that host only. Now we'll see the details. The hardware in FTTI provides mechanism for detecting, correcting problem on its own. The self-healing mechanism of the FTTI network is made possible by secondary. When a network error occurs or a host is down, the NIC of the host realizes that it cannot communicate with its neighboring host. In such case, the NIC uses the second ring, which is used as a backup for such failures for data transmission. This is called as a loopback. In figure shows one such instance where the host is temporarily down for some hardware failure. In such case, to bypass that host without affecting the rest of the network, the second ring is used. The purpose of the second ring, whenever the first ring is fails or the host on the ring fails and second ring is used to create another closed loop, bypassing the failed host to create the new closed loop. So this one is the self mechanism of the FTTI. So on this, if suppose you are getting the question, then you have to draw the diagram and then do the explanation. And this one is the repeated question in the exams. Now we'll see the Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a wireless LAN technology designed to connect devices of different functions, such as telephone, computers, cameras, printers, etc. In the Bluetooth, there are two types of the networks are used as an architecture. So one is the PicoNet, another one is the ScatterNet. So PicoNet, it is called a small net. PicoNet can have up to 8 stations, one of which is called as a primary and remaining all are called as a secondary. So as shown in diagram, one device has a primary and for that device, the connected the number of the devices, and those connected devices are considered as a secondary devices or secondary stations. Next one is the scatter net is the Piconets can be combined to form a scatter net. A secondary station is one piconet can be the primary in another piconet. This station can receive message from the primary in the first piconet and acting as a primary deliver to them the secondaries in the second piconet. A station can be member of two piconet. So as shown in figure. So first one is this one is the one piconet is there and this device is act as a secondary in the first piconet. The same device is again connected in the another one piconet and this time it act as a primary device for the other one devices. So this one is the scatter net. Means scatter net is the number of the piconets are combined. Cellular telephone. So this one is a setup for the cellular telephony. Public phone or this stationary phone is there. PSTN is there. MSC is there. Base station is there. Mobile station is there. And this one is the cell is there. Now we will see the explanation of this one. It is designed to provide communication between two moving units called a mobile station or between one mobile unit and one stationary unit, often called a land unit. A service provider must be able to locate and track a caller, assign a channel to the call, and transfer the channel from base station to the base station as the caller moves out of reach. To make this tracking possible, each cellular service area is divided into small regions called cells. Each cell contains an antenna and is controlled by a solar or AC powered network stations called the base station, that is the BS. Each base station in turn is controlled by a switching office called a mobile switching center, that is a MSC. The MSC coordinates communication between all the base station and the telephone central office. It is a computerized center that is responsible for connecting calls, recording information and billing. So this one is the cellular telephony. So this one question also you are getting for the 5 marks. So in that you have to draw the diagram and write the explanation. Now we will see the features of a wireless LAN. So first one feature, that is the Bluetooth architecture, defines two kind is services, that is BSS and extended service set. Station type based on their mobility in a wireless LAN. Third, MAC sublayer. Two sublayers are present in this MAC layer, distributed coordination function and a point coordination function. Next, fourth point, that is a fragmentation is fragmentation, then frame format and addressing mechanism. So these are the features of wireless LANs. This one also you are getting for the 5 marks question. Now we will see the flowchart for CD. So this question you are getting for the 10 marks. So you should draw this flowchart and then according to the flowchart you have to give the explanation. The first point, the station that has radio frame sets the back of parameters to the zero. Then it senses the line using one of the persistence strategy. This one. this one, it sees the persistence strategy. If this sends the frame, if there is no collision for the period corresponding to one complete frame, then the transmission is successful. So after the persistence strategy, it sends the frame, then it checks the collision. If suppose no collision, then your transmission is a success. If suppose the station during this collision checkup, it sends the jam signal because of the collision. The station then increment the back off time and wait for the random back off time and send the frame again. If the back off has reached its limit, then the station aborts the transmission. CSMACD is used for the traditional Ethernet. And is it important protocol? So in this you have to using this flowchart only you should explain the this flowchart. First set off the to the zero, then persistence strategy is there, then ready for the frame, and they are sending the frame. Whenever they are sending the frame, they are checking for the collision. If collision is occurred, then that frame is successfully transmitted. If collision is occurred, then they are sending the jam signal and increment back off. And then here there are now after sending the jam signal, they are waiting for the some ideal time, and then again they are retransmit the data. If suppose that back off time is finished, then they are abort the transmission. That is the explanation of the CDMA CD flowchart. And remember, this question you are getting for the 10 marks. So do the study on this chapter, and if suppose you have the any doubt, then ask me. Thank you.